What's up, folks? My name is Whitney, and we're going to work on an expert level GRE quantitative comparisons question. So you'll want to take a little over a minute to try this on your own, and then we'll talk about it together. Okay, rule one for all QC problems is to keep in mind this QC mantra of compare, don't compute, right? Before I even walk into reading any of the information in a QC problem, I'm trying to think to myself, if there are ways to avoid heavy mechanics or computation, I'm going to be looking for them, right? Because time is of the essence. So as I start to read information on the page, I'm looking for any patterns that could save me work. The first in this problem is our upfront information. So we're told that n is a positive integer. So language like positive and integer combined is a lot that we've been given. And for me, positive plus integer is starting to lead me into this thought of number properties type problems. So this would be evens or odds, positives, negatives, maybe even divisibility. But the one thing that all of these problems have in common is they tend to be very pattern heavy and a little bit gamey. So instead of computing, I might have just stumbled into a problem where I'm not going to have to do that at all. There's some more that starts to hint to me that we're in that family of number properties. A big one is this negative inside of parentheses with powers. Now, normally I would see powers and particularly variables in those powers as a reason to start doing like algebraic exponent rules, you know, like reducing bases and trying to solve. However, the fact that I already know we're talking about integers and now you're like tucking a negative into those powers says to me that, no, I think my gut was right to start with, that this really is going to be a positives and negatives problem. Why? Well, because a negative number, when raised to a power, is just going to switch its signs. So anytime I take a negative number and I raise it to an even power, so I square it or I raise it to the fourth power, it becomes positive. Every time I take a negative number and raise it to an odd power, so first power or third power, it's gonna hold on to its sign. So that's gonna be something that I would absolutely want you to notice about this problem. But there's actually a little bit of code that's even more glaring. And as an expert test taker looking for an expert score, you're gonna need to see these types of codes and recognize them almost immediately. So for this problem, the big codes are that 2n as a power and that 2n plus 1. So the moment I see 2n and I know that n is an integer, I know that the GRE just said to me, even. Now, if I see 2n plus 1 and I know that n is an integer, I'm immediately gonna translate that into odd. So I already now know that with negatives in my bases, with positive integer as my unknown, and then with even and odd as my power, this is 100% a positives and negatives problem. I don't even care what the numeric values of those bases are anymore. So let's look to see what it is exactly that we're being told in each of our quantities. So for quantity A, this negative 1, we're raising it to an even power. Well, a negative number raised to an even power, as I mentioned, is just going to be a positive number. 63, positive number, raised to, well, any power, is just going to stay positive. Now, on the right-hand side, for quantity B, we have our positive 7 raised to whatever power you want, staying positive. And then this negative number raised to an odd power is going to keep its sign. And so on quantity B side, we have the product of a positive times a negative, which results in a negative, while quantity A has a positive times a positive, leaving us a positive. So any positive number is bigger than any negative number. Quantity A is bigger than quantity B. And we didn't have to actually do any manipulating with real numbers. So in order to be that expert level test taker and get that expert level score, you have to be on the lookout for ways to avoid the algebra, look for the pattern, apply it quickly, and get to your answer, I think, a whole lot easier. Subscribe for more GRE Math Spotlight videos by Manhattan Prep, and then leave us a comment to tell us how you solved this problem. Happy studying!